Four, three.
What is going on?
That was kind of a speed rush.
I'm sitting on it. There we go.
Hey, man.
What's up?
That was a speed rush to get to this thing.
That was a little bit stressful.
That stressed me out to the max.
My adrenaline is just pumping right now. Golly.
Yeah, I'm a little bit amped.
I think I just got off the Judge Rory scream.
The what? Nice reference.
Yeah.
Man, I'm like real sweaty now.
Whew. Well, it's mainly because it's like 77 degrees in our office.
Yeah, that's a good point. I think this is still messed up.
Whew. Man. I bet people can hear my heartbeat through this mic right now. Aye, aye, aye.
Hey, buddy.
Hey.
I have no idea. I didn't check the audio. I literally just sprinted in here.
It sounds phenomenal.
I don't know if it's live on the broadcast. If you're on the broadcast, could you let us know if you can hear this? Whew. This is just like the making of a podcast.
Yeah.
We can take this out for the actual podcast, but live's live.
Yeah, I kind of like that we like have a countdown now that we have to be in here doing it.
I know we were 2 minutes before and I couldn't find you.
Like no, had to take a little tinkle.
Has anybody said if they can hear us?
I don't know. I'm getting to it right now.
Because that dictates if we do have audio or not.
Nobody has said anything.
And just to make it even better, the board isn't recording. This is pretty fascinating and professional.
There's audio.
We're good?
Yeah.
Sweet. How you doing, man?
I'm good.
Hey, this is the best week of the year.
Yes, it is.
The best week of the year.
Yep.
For a lot of reasons.
Because the weather.
Weather's great.
Because baseball is about to start.
1 week from Thursday.
And mainly because March Madness begins, I guess technically Tuesday. But
true.
Thursday, more so Thursday.
But we do have basketball to watch that are meaningful games on Tuesday.
Yeah. Yeah.
Which means a lot to me.
Which, Belmont's playing Tuesday, so I'm kind of interested. I think they're playing Tuesday. Tuesday or Wednesday, I don't know.
No, they're both Tuesday.
They're playing, oh, they are?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah. I think.
I know they have one of those play-in games, so.
Man.
Yeah.
This is the best week of the year.
It is.
I feel like even if you're not a basketball fan, you know about this week.
Yeah.
You still know that this week is happening, and it's the best. And we plan a trip around it every year.
Yep.
So we'll disappear for almost 5 days.
Of just pure bliss.
Basketball.
Pure bliss in Granbury, Texas.
Yeah.
On the lake.
Just fishing. Watching basketball.
Playing Farkle.
Just staying up late.
Kayaking.
Just having a slumber party.
Eating some Takis chips.
Bean dip. Probably some burgers and brats.
The weekly yum.
They will be there.
They will be there.
And hopefully providing great food.
I know Phil already said he's cooking up some jerky to bring. So that's going to be delicious.
Yeah. All of it. It's just the best. It's some of the best few days of my whole year.
Yeah.
Just in, like, you don't have to pack anything. Just bring like chill clothes. You don't have to do anything. People can sleep in. You can wake up at 10:59.
Mm-hmm.
Make it to the games. Got four TVs rolling.
Mm.
Fishing. We're right on the lake. Probably bringing kayaks.
Ripping some lips.
Just ripping lips.
It's even better this year because last year we kind of, it was like a last second. It's like, hey, we should do this.
Yeah.
I guess it wasn't completely last second, but it was somewhat last second. And
yeah.
This year, it's like we've had this planned and the place we're staying booked for, I feel like 6 months or more.
Yeah, I think we booked it in either August or September.
So it's been a lot of anticipation up to these next few days.
I know.
So that's awesome.
Last year we were so excited about fishing too.
And then we found out it was like 6 inches deep.
Yeah. That was it. There was no fish.
Braden almost dove on a jagged log because he lost Farkle.
Yeah. Yeah. Farkle's a great. If you don't know what Farkle is, Farkle's a dice game that we play where there really isn't a winner. There's just a loser.
Yeah.
If you get last place and before the game, we set something. Like, hey, you're going to have to go jump in the lake. Or you're going to have to eat this. Jared had to eat this real hot beef jerky.
Now that was Oh, yeah, that's we were playing Farquaad because of that.
Yeah, you just gave up mid-game because you were tired.
Yeah, I was like, man, it's like...
I got to be up in 4 hours.
3 a.m. I got to be up and, like, drive an hour and a half to Dallas the next morning. It's like, man, I can't play this any longer. I got to go get some sleep. So I just ate it. I didn't even lose. I was just like, man, I'm over it.
Yeah.
I'm going to eat this. I like spicy stuff. That was another level spicy, but it was worth it.
Yeah, worth it.
Did y'all keep playing? Did y'all finish the game?
No.
Because whoever actually lost that game owes me a bite of beef jerky.
So I was in the running to lose, and then two other people were. It was close. There were still people in, and also Braden quit, and Braden was in last.
That thing would have locked you up bad.
Oh, I smelled it and almost passed out.
I have this super, like, extremely spicy hot sauce that I might bring to March Madness in case we want to get a little spicy with our Farquaad bets.
Yeah, I'm out.
Nah, don't do that.
Of course I'll play.
You know you aren't going to lose.
I might.
You're the luckiest Farquaad player ever last year.
Yeah, I'm usually not, though. But I have been on a pretty great run.
Yeah.
So it's been nice. But yeah, this is the best week of the year for us. This is our favorite year. And the best part is it ends, you go back to work, and then baseball starts.
Yeah.
It's a great time.
Yep.
It's a really, really good time. But if you're listening, we are going to create a bracket and post it out in the next day or so. So if you want to join that, you can check the DesignWorks Group Facebook page or our Modern Mad Men Facebook page, and we'll have a bracket you can join and submit in. And the winner gets... Pride.
Yeah, pride.
You get to be the winner.
Yeah.
Last year, Caitlin won, so that can't happen again. Mm-hmm. Will you or I win?
No.
No.
There's not a chance.
Will we ever win?
This is probably as far as my Final Four, or I guess my Final Four and who I have winning it all, this is my most realistic year ever.
Yeah.
I do have almost every 13 seed and 12 seed winning.
Yep.
So.
Let's talk about that.
Yeah.
Let's talk about, we won't go through the whole bracket. The reason we were late to the live almost is that Jared is finishing up a full-size bracket for us for this trip, and we were going to use it, but there's not a lot of places to hang it in here.
Yeah.
We could have hung it behind us, but then we'd have to turn around.
Yeah.
Wouldn't have been awesome.
Not worth it.
But tell me who you, like, first round upsets or any teams that you're excited about.
Murray State is who I'm riding this year.
Okay.
Mainly because they were like one of the first people to punch their ticket into the tournament. And once I saw they punched their ticket, I was like, I think I already found my Cinderella team.
Yep.
Just because they have that one, they have a guard who is projected to be like a top 2 to 3 NBA draft pick. And apparently he's just a game changer. And that's usually one of the recipes for being a Cinderella team. You got to have that one player that can just be a game changer. But also
Steph Curry.
Yep.
Jimmer Fredette.
To a lesser extent, yes.
J.J. Redick.
Marshall Henderson.
Shout out to Bowie.
Yeah. But apparently they have a couple other guys that can hit three, so.
Yep.
And apparently this dude's a better passer than he is a scorer. So I feel like he'll be driving, they'll be collapsing on him.
Yep.
And that was a weird little stutter there.
Yeah, I didn't know what happened. I thought the audio messed up.
Whoa.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm good.
Okay, good.
And then dish it out, and hopefully if they can hit threes, I think they can make a run. So I have them, obviously I said that I picked most of the 12 and 13 seeds. I just have Murray State going all the way to the Final Four. Liberty, I think.
Wait, hold on. You have Murray State in your Final Four?
Yeah.
Let's roll.
Yeah, I have Murray State in my Final Four. Who else do I have going pretty deep? That's a lower seed. So I have Wofford as well in my Final Four. They're a 7 seed, so it's not a 12 seed, but that's still kind of a long shot. But I was just kind of feeling them. I have Oregon and Liberty making a little bit of a run. St. Mary's making a little bit of a run.
Okay.
Yeah, that's a few. Utah State, I have them playing Wofford to go to the Final Four.
Okay.
Yeah, that's about it.
Listen, here's my rule. If you pick 4 number one seeds in the Final Four, don't join our bracket.
Yeah, you aren't allowed. You aren't allowed in. We'll delete your bracket.
You don't want that.
Don't click the button that says pick top seed. Don't do that.
Now, if you click that button, will you have a better bracket than me? Probably.
Mm-hmm.
But will you have more fun watching the tournament than us? No. No way.
No.
So that's what I'm looking at. So here's what I've got. And I am more than ever confident in my Cinderella teams. Like, I'm actually embarrassed for their seeding. But I think that Murray State's going to be good. I picked them quick. But I think UC Irvine is going to be a problem.
Mm-hmm.
Real confident in that. I think Liberty has a chance to make a run.
Yeah, birdie.
Mainly because of the video I saw this morning of their music video. But the team that I'm most excited about, and when they go out in the first round and be devastated, but I think that Yale's going to beat LSU and make a run.
Dude, those Ivy League schools, they always have, they're just fundamental and they have shooters.
Yep.
They aren't like the most athletic, but they're fundamental and they have shooters.
Well, I was excited because they're playing LSU. LSU's had off the court problems. So I was like, oh, this is easy. But the problem with that too is that I feel like LSU, it's always that when that stuff happens, teams rally.
Mm-hmm.
So that might be a problem for
them. It was just their coach that got in trouble though, right?
Yeah, yeah. I thought there was more and I looked into it today.
But like, losing a coach going into like the biggest tournament ever.
Yeah, yeah.
A pretty big deal.
Or you rally.
Or you rally.
You get hot for a game, play for him. But I think Yale's going to be a problem.
Yeah.
I'm real confident in that one. The three teams I like that are lower seeds. Is it lower seeds? What's a better seed? Is that a higher seed?
I guess technically a higher seed would be like a one seed, right? One seed. Yeah. But it doesn't sound right.
But you're lower because you're, I don't know.
But better and worse seed.
I like Duke a lot.
Mm-hmm. I do like Duke a lot. I have them winning the whole thing.
I do too.
I wish they weren't a one seed.
Yeah.
But I do have them winning the whole thing.
I didn't even put Duke on my bracket though. I just put Zion.
Yeah.
On each one.
Yeah.
I like Texas Tech a lot. I think they have a legitimate chance to get out of their bracket. And I really like Houston. And Houston is my final four.
Really?
Yep.
You have them winning it all? Or you have Duke winning it all?
I have Duke winning it all in that first bracket I did. I might mix it up. But I think that when will they play UNC? Early? No, later. I don't know.
Yeah, they would be later because they're like in the bottom of this bracket and North Carolina is at the top. So I think they would play North Carolina to go to the Final Four.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, so I think I think they'll beat UNC to go to the Final Four.
Oh, no, to the Elite Eight, sorry.
No, they'd be the Final Four. No, you're right.
They're both in the Midwest.
You're right. Yeah, you're right.
Oh, no, it would
be Final Four.
Sorry.
Because they would play each other.
Yeah, yeah.
They're at the bottom.
Yeah, you're right.
Opposite ends of that bracket. But, yeah. Yeah, I think Houston's going to be a problem. I think Texas Tech's going to be a problem. Also, I think Duke is either going to win this tournament or I feel like they always get upset.
Yeah.
So, who knows? And Duke's in the same part of the bracket as Yale.
They kind of got a different team this year.
They have a different player.
Yeah.
Now they have a different team for sure. But you know who else has a different team? Yale.
Mm-hmm.
I've been a Yale fan my whole life.
I know you have.
Have not missed a Yale basketball game in 15 years.
You told me that yesterday.
When I found them. I found out they had a basketball team. But yeah, that's my predictions. Will I change those 25 times before 11 o'clock on Thursday? Probably. But I'm going to try to stay under three brackets this year.
Yeah.
Too many brackets just cause too much problems.
Yeah.
So I'm going to make a master bracket. I'll do a coin flip bracket. And then I'll do another random bracket.
My whole bracket's going to ride on Murray State, probably. Them and Duke.
Yeah.
Them and Duke.
You're putting a lot on the line with Murray State, and I appreciate that.
But last year I called Loyola Chicago, and they made a little run for me.
They did.
And they're the only reason I didn't get last place.
Yep.
Because, obviously, my bracket's always jacked up. But the fact they went far, I was like the only person, one of the few people that had them going far, and they got me a bunch of points every week.
I got second in our league because of Villanova.
Yeah.
I picked them to win it.
I don't even remember who I picked last year.
Only two people in our whole bracket picked Villanova to win.
I feel like I might have picked Villanova, actually.
Well, then you were so far down the thing, I couldn't see your score.
Can we go back to last year's groups?
Now? I can't for my the device I'm on now. But, yeah, I am I'm pretty excited.
So am I. It's going to be fun.
It's going to be really fun.
It's going to be real fun.
I feel like I'm just like, I came into this podcast just flustered. I feel like I just need to sit here for a minute.
That's probably my fault.
No, man, I
should have been in here earlier.
We plugged in the, to record, and it didn't even record. And then it was like, we looked down at the clock, and there's 4 seconds on the clock. And then when it went live, I looked, and the recording screen was like all the way off, and the logo was messed up. And so I was like, whatever.
Well, I think it's working.
Yeah, it's pretty bush league off the front, but we're here. It's March Madness week.
All two of our listeners right now are getting some insider tips about March Madness.
So. No, you're confused. That two is 1,000.
It's 2,000. I forgot that it started counting.
Yeah, it's weird.
In thousands.
Yeah, it's a weird thing.
Yeah.
When you have this level of account, that's just kind of how it works.
Yeah.
So here's what we're going to talk about today. Here's the main part of this podcast. We'll try to get another one out before we leave. I think we can.
Are we taking it on the road?
I'm trying. I'm working on getting some mics. If we can do that, then absolutely. Will those be live? No.
Yes, yeah, so that'd probably be a good idea not to go live.
But we will record if I can get my hands on these other mics. Cool. But here's what I'm talking about today for business owners. How can people... So March Madness is what we're talking about today, but it can be the Super Bowl, Grammys. Do people watch the Grammys?
Yeah.
The Bachelor, anything... Maybe not The Bachelor, but anything that a large group of people traditionally would gather around and watch, like the Super Bowl or March Madness. Everyone would get in a room and watch it. And as time's going on, I didn't bring the stats with me, but like the consumption of how people watch March Madness, whether it be on their phone, a tablet, streaming service, YouTube TV, it's constantly evolved. So what I want to hear from you, the expert, is how can people leverage like big events for social media? So maybe your product has nothing to do with March Madness and basketball. Maybe you don't like it. But one thing we do know is that the viewership on social media, on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, will be higher because of March Madness.
Yeah.
So how can you leverage that to get more people to know about your product, to learn about your product, and to use your stuff?
So I think, I feel like a lot of people have events in the, if you're like a restaurant, you have like specials going on during it. So I think whether you're like having a watch party at your business or whatever, just like utilizing that to like go live. Like, I think that's a prime time to like go live and just show how much fun people are having at your business.
Yep.
And I think building like, as far as like, if you're like a product based company, just building like some quick videos around your product that associate March Madness or like, or basketball theme somehow. So I think those are two like real simple ways. And then obviously, if you are hosting events, creating like events on social media and getting those out there, but then like within those events, like building it out some and posting content around it, whether it's you being live or just pictures of people at the event, especially with March Madness, because it's like a multiple week thing. So if you're like showing people having like a lot of fun at these watch parties, if you're having a watch party, then they might like not go to the first one, but you have an opportunity to have another one because it's like a multiple week thing. So I don't know. I think that whether you're a restaurant, or just kind of like a, hangout place, I think watch parties, food specials, even like coming up with drinks for certain teams or something like that. I think that's great. And then, just building, if you sell product, building content that's basketball themed, whether it's a video, graphic, or whatever, I think it's a few pretty simple ways.
Yeah, yeah.
That you don't have to spend a lot of time doing.
Yeah, I think if you're a B2B company, so if you work with other businesses, you have meetings with other businesses. I think this is a prime time during March Madness to leverage having other people in your industry come into your office and have a place they can watch March Madness games, have some drinks and hang out. Because it's harder. I mean, I'm not saying you should game the system, but it's easy to get people in your doors to hang out. We used to do like a, we did a watch party for the World Cup. And we did it, I think the World Cup, that game started at like 3 or 4.
There's a bunch of people here for
that. Yeah, because people are during work hours.
Yeah.
And it's networking, it's business, they can get, and their boss will let them go. I think it's just a way to get people in the doors. You can have a meeting, but have some food, have some drinks.
Yeah.
The games are going on from 11:15 a.m. till midnight.
Yeah.
Just all day running.
Yep.
It's a chance for you during work hours to leverage it, not be afraid of it. That was one of the things that clicked for me on the actual March Madness app, is it has that boss button. That like, when you're watching the games, in the top left-hand corner, it says like boss button or boss emergency, and you click it, and the whole screen goes from the basketball game to a spreadsheet. So like, they know clearly that their audience that's watching it at work are people like that work. And so not everyone like us takes that time off because we're responsible.
Yeah, for sure.
We would never do that.
Yeah.
So the bummer is March Madness is so close to opening day.
I know.
So we're going to take off the next week and then every Ranger game after that.
Yeah.
We miss a lot of work.
This is like the prime time to leverage events for your social media.
Yeah, I think also too, realizing that all those people that are sitting at their desks that are being way less productive, if they're in your buying audience, they're also getting on Facebook and talking about the game. They're on Twitter, they're on Instagram looking. And so I think it's an opportunity, even with a creating good content, even if it has nothing to do with March Madness, but you create good content and use that time to boost it, to begin to run ads, target ads. Those people are on way more. They're on way more at night. A lot of the world does stop during this time so people can watch these games.
Mm-hmm.
And when people stop, even if they're at Buffalo Wild Wings or wherever, they're on their phone. So I think you have a huge leverage point to run ads. I think the viewership on social, I can't remember, I had all the stats, but it's a lot higher during the season.
Yeah. And then just taking the time to, like, interact if fans are talking about it. If they're talking, like, a specific game, if they're tweeting about a specific game, or they're post a picture of them watching a March Madness game with a group or whatever, just interacting with it and, like, being fun with it.
Yep.
And, like, being part of the conversation. Even if you don't know who they are.
Like, yeah.
Just interact. Like, if you see somebody tweeting about it or posting on Facebook about it, like, take the time to end up in those comments.
Yeah. Create content around it, like you said. Like, create a bracket and have people, like, give away an Alexa, mm-hmm, or give away a Google Home or whatever. But create content, drive people to interact with you. That's just one of those things that I know we've been working on, is that if more people are going to be utilizing social media Thursday and Friday especially, probably Saturday and Sunday as well, like, why wouldn't we, instead of running a Super Bowl commercial on TV, why don't we create that same content and run it while people are on Facebook during the Super Bowl?
Mm-hmm.
So it's the same concept. And I think that people forget that they don't have to buy a TV spot or a radio spot. They can actually utilize the platform that everybody's on.
Yeah.
I mean, Twitter's going to be, a lot of people are on Twitter, but especially in the local market, Facebook and Instagram are going to be huge. And so even if you don't have a basketball in your picture and you don't have a business where you can do drink specials, you actually sell B2B or whatever, those people are all watching,
mm-hmm,
or at least checking more. I think you have a huge opportunity to leverage that right now.
Yeah, for sure.
Contests, anything. But yeah, I think like everything we talk about on the podcast, but reverse engineering, who are you going after and what would they be doing? And I think that if you did that, most businesses would see that this is a time that you could really, really leverage paid media and organic media on social media.
Yeah.
So we got to figure that out for us in the future on some of these. But yeah, I don't know. I think that people get it confused with TV too much.
Yeah.
And I think they forget when anybody, I think you're just looking at human behavior now. When you look and people gather for anything, then they're usually on their phone because they want people to know they're doing it. And so once Yale makes this run of the year, then
you're going to sound like a genius.
I am. When they go out first round, it's going to look bad.
We can edit the podcast. Can't edit the live video, but
just delete it.
That's true.
Just get rid of it.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think people miss out on this way too much.
Yeah.
I think they assume that they have to buy a TV spot, which is great too, if you can get in front of people. But I think being able to create contests or any kind of organic content. And I would, if I were you and you're a business owner listening right now, I would dump double or triple your budget you normally spend in a week on Thursday and Friday. I would cramp it down.
Yeah.
What do you think? You're the expert in that.
No,
Am I wrong? If I am wrong,
I
don't stay on the podcast.
Because, yeah, I think there's going to be a lot more people online, like even at work online, either checking their bracket or whatever, even if they don't have a bracket, they'll probably still be online keeping up with everything. And usually, I think most people, after they check their bracket, they're probably just naturally going to head over and check what's good on Facebook.
Yeah.
So they'll probably end up on Facebook or Twitter or something just after checking up on whatever.
Yeah. There's a lot of feel-good stories, too.
Yeah.
That come from the tournament that we have no idea what's about to happen. And you learn about people, and then you get on Facebook and you see their stories. And so I think that it's really, really going to be. I mean, obviously, I think it's easy for people like in the food industry to see this is a great time to leverage. But I think a lot of people in the B2B world, or even people that sell software, or if you have like a clothes store, I think it's a huge opportunity,
mm-hmm,
to like, hey, pick a team. If you get the right team, you can get this much off. That's easy. It's an offer. But to actually not try to sell anything during this time. Like, if you don't have anything specific to sell, don't invest the money in trying to create something to sell. Because we've seen that a lot with contests.
Mm-hmm.
People run a contest. They try to give away a TV, and then their audience is not the right audience. But to use this as a time to actually educate or get in front of more people.
Yeah. Also, don't use like these events as an opportunity to like reply and comment on people's posts that are talking about the event with a sales pitch about your product.
Yep.
If you're going to comment or reply, make it like relevant to what they're talking about. Yep. Instead of just doing something that seems super body and leaving a sales pitch.
Yep.
Like, it's okay if you don't know the person, if you're like contributing to the conversation, but it's probably not okay if you don't know the person, even probably if you do know the person, just to hop in their, on their comments. Yep. Or reply to them with a just straight up sales pitch.
Yeah. Like we're not in a discount industry.
Yeah. Just try not to shut down the conversation.
Yeah.
Just like, keep going.
We're not for us going to use this time as an opportunity to try to get offer 15% off websites.
Yeah.
Or, I mean, we're going to run, we want to do this bracket to get in front of more people, to give more people the opportunity to know who we are.
Yeah.
But at the end of the bracket, like, you're not going to sign up for a bracket with us and then get a follow-up email.
Yeah.
On how our services can help them.
Mm-hmm.
Because we're not that, we're too early in the conversation. We're just going to get more people to know about us. And so, yeah, I think that's been a problem for a lot of people, is they feel like they have to sell now. Whereas if you can use this as, I mean, organic stuff's free.
Yeah.
I mean, it just takes your time to create the content. But like the weekly yum, what could the weekly yum do? More people are going to be online. They're growing a new business. If you were going to talk to these guys, I mean, I have no idea what they're doing. If you were going to talk to the weekly yum, what would you tell them to do Thursday and Friday?
I would tell them to get some stuff going online.
And to create more food for us.
To create, yeah, for sure, create more food for us. But, I mean, they're both going to be there with us watching these games.
Yep.
In a cabin.
Yep.
So that's like a perfect time for them to get some content out of them.
Yeah. During March Madness, do you want to go and go home and cook?
And there's probably going to be some of their food there.
Yep.
So they can just post some pictures of us all enjoying their food and be like, need some food for a party?
Yeah.
Boom.
Yeah. Do you want to go home at night on Thursday and Friday night, Saturday and Sunday, and have to cook?
No.
Or would you rather have it all prepared and it be delicious? And so you have just time to watch the game.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think that they're good about it too. Not everything's a sales pitch.
Yeah.
You know, not everything's got to be an offer code. Not everything, just getting in front of people is some of the best content we've ever done. One of our best videos ever was you racing Tyler in the parking lot.
Well, that's because everybody saw how fast I was.
Yeah, you lost by 30 yards in a 40-yard dash.
Oh, man.
Yeah, I think that's the biggest sell for me. If you're a business owner, use this as a time to be a part of the conversation and to help create conversation, but not to steer the conversation to just your product.
Yeah.
Because you're in a bind.
Especially since you didn't start the conversation.
Yeah.
Like, don't try to take over the conversation and steer it your direction.
Yeah.
When you didn't start it.
Like the point was exactly what we just did with the weekly yum.
Mm-hmm.
Like, not everything's got to be leveraged. Like, I don't know. I think that's just a frustrating thing for me, especially on social media. If you run a TV spot, great. But if you're on social media, I think you have to use that to be a part of the conversation.
Mm-hmm.
And I think you can guide the conversation, ask questions, give people a platform to talk. But I don't think you have to be the only, like, I think we should do that now. Go the opposite route.
Just hit up all the comments.
Yeah.
With we just type something out, copy and paste it, and just in all the comments, the exact same comment.
Yeah. Or customize it a little bit where it's like, man, I just checked the ESPN app and Yale's killing LSU. And it's like, oh, speaking of apps, did you know that we can develop an app for you? You know? Like, man, it's so cool to be able to sit at my desk and just get on this March Madness website and watch all the games. Like, oh.
Did you know we can make websites?
We can. So I think that's what we should do.
Yeah.
We should go the exact opposite direction this year.
Yeah. See what happens.
Just try to sell everything.
Yeah.
Someone just posts on Facebook about nothing. Like, oh, you posted on Facebook. Do you know that we post on Facebook for people?
Mm-hmm.
We could do that for you.
I bet we'd make a ton of sales.
We probably would. And we would lose a ton of business.
Yeah, probably.
We should do that on every business we know that just posts.
Mm-hmm.
Anything. But, oh, hey, guys, it's Jared Van from DesignWorks. Just wanted to know if you wanted us to take over your social media. Thanks. Just like a picture of some food. Click here to fill out the form.
It's a great idea.
Yeah, don't do that.
But not really. Yeah, don't do that.
Don't do that. What did Heath say?
He said that we should check the fantasy football market. He said that he literally has to bring his charger to work on Sundays during football season, and he feels like I'm not doing enough at work. I feel bad, but dang, I love fantasy football.
Yeah.
So yeah,
that's another huge leverage point, especially if you want to, if you have a real technically, like a really niche market, and getting in some of that. That's one of the few times I think banner ads could be, could bring an ROI.
Yeah.
If you can get into some of these and run banner ads, because I know during March Madness or during fantasy football season, if I don't have anything to do on a Sunday, which is rare, then I do spend a lot of time watching. On my points just tick up.
Yeah, you're either, I'm either like in the app, whatever platform we're playing on, or like I'm on the ESPN app.
Yeah,
checking scores,
just checking.
So yeah, I think that is a pretty decent opportunity for banner ads.
Yeah, it can be. It doesn't always have to be sports. You know, I think sports is just a big part of what we watch, but it could be anything that you know a lot of people are going to sit down and watch.
Mm-hmm.
What is it? What's another one? People, a lot of people watch the Grammys and Oscars.
I
know Twitter blows up.
Yeah, I don't know the exact numbers on that. I think the Grammys are probably the most popular one.
Yeah,
you know, I'll always enjoy watching the Grammys.
You know, like a Tuesday night when everyone's sitting down to watch America's Funniest Home Videos.
Oh yeah,
you know, you're like, yeah. Hey, this would be a great time to post something.
Mm-hmm.
You know that he has a new show.
Does he really?
He does.
Who?
Bob Saget.
Oh, I did see that on Netflix.
It's called.
I'm pretty sure Carlton hosts America's Funniest Home Videos now.
Yeah, so Bob Saget's show, I don't know what, I saw it on YouTube TV, but it's called like Videos After Dark.
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
and it's the adult version of America's Funniest
Home Videos. Oh, is that
what it is? Yeah. It's just like America's Funniest Home Videos, but with like a little more crude humor.
That makes sense.
Yeah. It's basically since that show, though, there's been 1,000 of those. Ridiculousness.
Yeah.
Tosh was kind of that.
Yeah. Dude, it was... That was America's Funniest Home Videos with Bob Saget. That was one of the best things ever.
That was a time, though, that you couldn't go and... Like, you, it wasn't as easy to go find those videos.
Yeah. Like, you wouldn't find them online, necessarily.
Yeah. And then it was hard to tell your friends about it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, listen. So this guy's wife is pitching to him, and then he hits it, and he hits her in the face.
Come on, bro.
And it's the funniest thing you've ever seen.
That was not funny. Yeah, I mean, I'm sure it might have been for...
But if it was on video, it would have been funny for other people, not you.
Yeah, yeah.
And for sure not Emily.
Yeah.
It would have been real funny to see Emily hitting you with that bat.
Yeah.
But you couldn't tell people. You had to tell, like, describe it, and it's never funny when you describe a video.
Yeah, especially that video.
Well, no. I'm just saying.
Oh, no.
Bad example.
Yeah. No, yeah.
Now you just get on YouTube, and you just type in World Star Hip Hop Fight Compilation. And then there goes 6 hours of your day.
Yep. Or you look at your watch and realize it's 6 a.m. and it's time to wake up.
You mean just get up at that
get
point?
Up, yeah, get up off the couch.
It's time to be awake.
It's time to get ready for the day.
Yeah, I could not be more excited about March Madness.
Mm-hmm. It came out quick.
It did. This whole year's gone by real fast.
It's already almost April.
I know, which is baseball season.
Yep.
While we're making predictions... do you have a Rangers prediction?
74 wins.
Okay.
They're going to average giving up about 8 runs a game.
Okay.
That still might be high, because that's a lot.
But Hunter Pence might be
getting... Hunter Pence might be getting 8 RBIs a game by himself.
I'm saying 88 wins.
88?
Yeah.
So they're going to be above 500.
Yeah, and I think that they're going to slow down at the end of the season.
So I guess I'm predicting them, what would that be, 74 and 88?
Yeah. I think the Rangers will be leading the division at the end of May. Dang. And then I think they'll just sneak into a wild card.
Dang.
That's my prediction.
That's a pretty bold prediction.
Yeah, I think they're going to be real hot in April. Lose a couple games early, but just be hot through April, hot enough through May to survive it, and then we'll see what happens at the All-Star break when Josh Hamilton comes back.
I hope you're right about both of those.
Yeah.
How their season goes and Josh Hamilton coming back.
I think Hunter Pence might be an actual player. Like, he might actually play games.
He should.
We'll see.
According to how he's done in spring training.
They said statistically it's the best spring training ever. I just made that up. I have no idea. I haven't checked really anything else on him. But yeah. We'll try to get one more out before we leave. This has been like the world's most rushed podcast ever.
Mm-hmm.
We had big plans for it, but we had to get it done today.
Yep.
You were in there stapling together. what's that stuff called?
It's supposed to be lamination.
Lamination.
but apparently the lamination machine was not working.
Yeah.
So then I was literally like just placing the loose pieces of plastic that were the lamination onto the poster board and stapling it on, which I think it worked. That was your great idea. Why don't you just staple it? I was trying to tape it, but why don't you just staple it?
I think tape made sense though. If you'd had the right kind of tape.
Yeah. Your idea was a lot quicker and a lot smarter.
Yeah.
Good job, man. You saved the bracket.
Yeah. I was kind of bummed about that falling apart on you though, because the bracket looks good.
Yeah. There's one poster board that looks good that we had to go back and redo. And by we, I mean Emily, because I don't know how to work a laminator. But now I do. So, yeah.
You're a pro now.
I'm a pro now.
It's the best week of the year for us. It's our favorite week. We're going to try to get as much content out as we can. And yeah, if you're a business owner, leverage this time. Even if you don't like sports, just know that there will be sports on Thursday through Sunday, basically all day, which means more people will be watching and on social media. So leverage that to create content now, put stuff out now. And if you have money and you use a budget, I would shrink the budget. I would really invest it in those days. Because then the following weekend, you have more watched games probably, but less time.
Yeah.
Because you narrow that bracket down to, what, after the first weekend, you're 16?
Yeah.
So you go 16, 8 the next weekend, and the weekend after that would be 4 in the championship.
I think deep down, everybody likes the first two rounds the most.
Yeah.
So I think that's when, I could be completely wrong.
It's a real bummer after the first weekend. If you don't really have any high seeds left for a lot of people.
Yeah.
But you can keep a lot of interest. Like that year Butler made a run.
Yep.
And he almost hit that buzzer beater to beat Duke in the championship. Oh, my goodness.
Last year with my boys, Loyola.
Yep. Florida Gulf Coast. Made an amazing run.
That was a fun one.
Davidson made a great run. They were pretty high seed.
That was a super fun one.
BYU made a great run. Man, there's been so many through the years. Yeah. But that's what makes it fun.
Yep.
That's why I think it's the greatest tournament. Maybe not the greatest sport, but it's the greatest tournament.
Yeah, I would agree with that.
What other tournament goes with 64 teams?
None. Besides like...
Women's like March Madness.
Like the World Cup, maybe.
Yeah, I don't think it's 64, though.
I have no idea. They have like...
A lot.
Group A through H or something like that.
And it's a lot.
Four teams in each group.
So quite a bit. Close. Yeah. Quick math.
8 times 4, 32 maybe?
Yeah.
32 teams? I don't know.
But yeah, take this time to leverage, create content, and don't sell. What is your words of the day for the people?
I do not know. You want to go first, or did you already give yours? I always have to make you go first, so I can just like slightly tweak yours and make it.
I'm gonna go in opposite directions because we just talked about this the whole time. I just came back from an awesome wedding this weekend. That's my whole thing.
But then you look great in the picture you sent.
Oh yeah, the cowboy hat?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You look great.
Thanks for posting that.
You just look natural.
No, I think just the same thing. Like, utilize things like March Madness, not only to create good content, but also go have a beer with somebody.
Yeah.
Or have somebody over your house and watch a game. Or just invest the time to have good people around you that when the party's over, they're still there.
Mm-hmm.
So that's my thing. I probably should be more business related, but I would definitely invest in heavy relationships now.
That's somewhat business related, though.
It'll definitely give you longevity
in
the days that you want to quit and the years you want to quit. But yeah, I would definitely, that's what I'm most excited about this trip is, do I love basketball? Yes. But is it nice to just kick it with the boys?
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Rip lips? Yep.
Rip lips.
Watch basketball. Maybe drink a couple hard ciders or a Zima.
Zima for sure.
You never know.
That's all I'm bringing.
It might get wild. But at the end of the day, I think having good people around you that love you, that don't just say yes to you, and that force you to do something different.
Yep. Ditto.
Ditto.
I'm having a hard time today.
Can I tell you that I'm real impressed with you, though?
Why is that?
That you made it through this podcast. We were a little flustered, but you came in with 3 seconds on the clock. And made it through the podcast. So good for you.
I haven't fallen asleep yet.
No, and you did a great job, I think, navigating it.
I'm starting to die a little bit. My energy level's starting to go down a little bit. I feel like I started off pretty good though.
Yeah, I'm tired today.
But we are at minute like 37. And I've lasted that long.
That's good.
Mm-hmm.
And hopefully it worked because we have no recording otherwise.
I know. I think it did.
That's the beauty of this, though.
I don't know.
We're figuring it out as we go.
Yeah.
This is only our third live.
Yeah.
We've dropped the ball in each one of them in different ways.
Yeah.
Failing forward.
Failing forward. That's
failing forward.
That's the word. That's my word for the people.
There
it just
is.
Came. It just hit me. Don't.
Oh, what is it?
Don't be afraid to fail. And don't quit if you do fail, unless it's like, I don't know. Sometimes I think quitting might be necessary, but if you fail once, don't quit. Learn from it and move on.
Yeah. I think there's also a difference between quitting and changing routes.
And transitioning.
Yeah.
Yeah. So don't be afraid to transition if you're failing a ton.
Yeah.
But also don't be afraid to fail. You can learn stuff from it.
Fail forward.
Yeah. Yeah.
That was a great word, man.
Yeah. That just hit me.
Yeah. Sometimes wisdom just comes out of nowhere.
I know. And sometimes it comes out of the mic next to me.
Yeah. Your mic.
No.
That was yours, man. You pulled that out of me.
Yeah, it was.
You pulled that out of me. I don't know, man. I just could not be more excited. I'm exhausted physically and mentally, but I am excited to just take a few days, take a deep breath, in some ways disconnect.
Mm-hmm.
Even though we're technically very connected with all the TVs and probably the brackets, but...
I'm about to be live 24/7.
Just commentating?
Yeah. No, that sounds about like the worst thing for me.
But yeah, I'm excited to disconnect for a few days and enjoy. We will try to do another podcast, you think?
Yeah.
We'll get one out maybe Wednesday.
For sure.
If we do it early enough in the day, that'll give you time to get it uploaded. If we do get... I don't think you would release anything while we're there, though. I don't think you're going to want to do it, man.
Probably not.
I would say no.
I'm probably not going to take my computer.
Best case scenario, we'll backlog a bunch of podcasts.
Yeah.
I'm definitely taking my computer.
Are you?
Yeah. That's how I'm going to be checking the brackets.
That's why you got a phone.
Nah. I like a bigger screen.
Okay.
Plus, I'm going to probably have to play YouTube TV off of it. Realistically.
Don't you...
My Xbox will do it, but I don't know how many logins we have.
Can't you just play it through your... Oh, no. You play it through your I forgot you play it through your Xbox.
Yep. Makes it a lot easier. Well, cool, man. Thanks for the words of wisdom.
Yep. It was a good one.
Good luck on your bracket.
Thank you.
If you're listening still, thanks for listening. We will post our bracket on the DesignWorks page and on the Modern Madman page.
Mm-hmm.
We'd love it if you take a few seconds... Especially if you're on Apple, go to iTunes, hit subscribe on the podcast, search Modern Mad Men, all separate words, and leave us a review. And if you have questions, you can always comment on the live video, or you can call in at
940-247-0807.
Yeah. So leave us, sorry, I got a WD-40 in this thing.
Yeah,
it's driving
that was,
me
that was squeaky.
Wild.
That was a little bit squeaky.
It's driving me wild. Only right there. Yeah, that's Bush League.
Yeah.
We'll figure it out, though. Yeah, leave us a review, hit us up, and we'll put another one out this week. Anything else?
Nope.